Here, I have drawn a Jablonski diagram representing the various vibrational energy states that a molecule or population of molecules can exist in. For any given sample, the population of some energy state can be estimated by the Boltzmann distribution showing the vibrational energy's dependence on temperature. The Jablonski diagram is useful for visualizing the quantum energy states that a species can exist in, and also model changes of that system by defining the vibrational energy states of some molecule as Planck's constant times the frequency of vibration. Each vibrational state is directly proportional to the vibrational frequency of the species occupying that state. So, if we define that species as this carbon nanosheet, several types of vibration can occur. However, we will focus on just the planar molecular vibrations that directly correspond to the electrons and protons that are interacting, also referred to as some polarizability ellipsoid. Photons also have some discrete energy levels, denoted by Planck's constant times the frequency of that photon. So, the energy of that photon is directly proportional to the frequency of the electromagnetic field generated by that photon, which is denoted by, the frequency is denoted by V0, or the incident photon's frequency. So, if you shot a photon into some carbon nanotube, the electromagnetic field generated by the photon's energy state, HV0, will polarize and vibrate the electromagnetic field generated by the molecule sinusoidally. This induced dipole will now vibrate with some frequency, V0 from the incident photon, plus V vibrational of the molecule, denoted as VF. So, it is helpful to model this energy change with a Jablonski diagram. On the left side of this diagram, I have shown the induced energy state of the molecule, whose change equals the incident photon's frequency V0 times Planck's constant. This energy transfer will result in a scattered photon. In Stokes scattering, the photons scatter with less energy and thus decrease frequencies, shown here by green and red deflected photons, or electromagnetic radiation, whose new energy state is if experiencing Stokes scattering due to the interaction with the molecule's polarizability ellipsoid will be decreased. So a loss of energy, essentially, due to this interaction with the molecule's dipole, this induced dipole. So we can model this reduced energy state by saying that the photon experienced some loss of frequency via inducing a dipole, and the resulting frequency times Planck's constant will be the shifted energy. We may also model elastic collisions with no net exchange in energy, resulting in scattered photons with the same incident frequency. Finally, in the last case, anti-Stokes scattering can occur where the scattered photon now has an energy of V0 plus V vibrational times Planck's constant. So, in review, the incident photons can experience inelastic scattering and elastic scattering. Inelastic, represented by Stokes scattering, is a loss in energy by the induced dipole of the molecule. Conversely, anti-Stokes scattering results in scattered light with higher energy from constructive induced dipole interactions. Finally, elastic scattering resulting in scattered light with the same energy as the incident light. So, all of these transitions or changes in light can be modeled as shifts in wavelength because of Planck's law. E equals the Planck's constant times frequency is also equal to Planck's constant times the speed of that photon in whatever medium it is, divided by its wavelength. So imagine you have some laser at 758 nanometers projecting into a carbon nanotube, interacting with its G-band. And so you can denote this shift in wavelength from the scattered light from the incident photon's wavelength as the change in the wave number. or 1 over the incident wavelength minus 1 over some induced wavelength of electromagnetic radiation from field interactions and vibrational energy of the molecule. So you have this incident 758 nanometers causing irradiation of 861.13 nanometers. That would be a wave number of 1580 inverse centimeters. So here we understand also the underlying difference between UV-Vis and Raman spectroscopy. That is to say that the incident photon energy in Raman spectroscopy is much lower than in UV-Vis, and thus the induced molecular energy is vibrational instead of electronic.